We fucking lie. You know why? Because we can't read minds yet. That's the next stage of human evolution for sure. And we see little sprinkles of it every now and then in your life. You ever be thinking about somebody and they call? You're like, what the fuck is that? What is that? Why does it happen so often? That's some shit, people. We're slowly learning how to read each other's minds. And when we do, liars are gonna be fucked. We all know a lot. Religion's gonna go out of business. They're gonna fuck guys like Ted Haggard and all those crazy cocksuckers. They're never gonna be able to pull off a scam ever. You know who I'm talking about? You guys know who Ted Haggard is? And this is taking nothing away from really religious people who really believe in it and help a lot of people. And I know a lot of friends that have been helped by religion. That's absolutely a fact. But there's some fake people out there. And one of them was this guy, Ted Haggard, who was awesome because this guy was the head of a gigantic congregation in Colorado Springs where he'd have like 15,000 dudes in a stadium. They'd all be holding hands and talking about stopping the gay agenda. It was fucking psycho shit. Right? They're all preaching for Jesus and go. And this guy, the whole time he was doing this, was steady smoking crystal meth and having sex with gay prostitutes. I mean, he's just insane. The guy was completely out of his mind. He was getting gay hookers from Craigslist. Like, who are they gonna tell? Just completely out of his mind. And they catch him, and he doesn't admit to it at first. It was an awesome thing. They got to him, he's like, well, yeah, I had the meth, but I threw it out. And with as far as him, he just gave me a massage. Like, whoa, did you even think that fucking answer out? He figures I've been bullshitting people my whole life. They believe everything I say. Shit. Telling them about people walking on water and they're fine with that. They don't believe I got a massage. What the fuck? Fairly reasonable. So they catch this guy. I mean, it's ridiculous. It's on CNN. The gay hooker goes on CNN, tells the whole seedy story. And you figure with a guy like that, well, he's obviously a hypocrite. They're just going to get rid of him. No, they didn't get rid of him. They cured him. You can't write shit like this. This is real life. They took four pastors and they spent 3 weeks alone with him in a cabin and they cured him of his homosexuality. Now, I don't know how they did it, but I assume they probably did it the same way my dad got me to quit smoking. I think they made that motherfucker smoke the whole pack. That's what I think. I think they just popped Viagra and fucked his face for 3 weeks. Just smack, smack. Do you love Jesus? Mascara running, snot and tears. I do love Jesus. I think you like dick more. Smack, smack. All day for 3 weeks. That'll cure you, man. By the end of those 3 weeks, you go, no more dicks for me, please. I don't see another dick for the rest of my life. Might not have happened like that, but a boy can dream.